Hello everyone. So today we are going to start a series on chemistry plus 2 standard, chapter number 2, solutions. The first topic here we are going to take is concentration terms. Let us start with a very good thought: hard work pays off. So if you are doing hard work, definitely you will get success. Let us start. So learning objectives. So students will be able to learn about the measures of concentration at terms. What is solution? Solution, you know, that's it's a combination of solute and solvent, but it's a homogeneous one. This is the keyword we need to keep in mind. Homogeneous and heterogeneous solutions can be one of the type, because if the constant composition is there throughout, then it's homogeneous. If it's not, then heterogeneous. Dilute or concentrated solution, self-explanatory. Acidic, basic or neutral solution, pH is less than 7, that is acidic, equal to 7, greater than 7 is alkaline. Isotonic, hypertonic and hypotonic. If pressure is more, then is hyper. If same, iso. If it's less, hypo. Hyper means high. Next please. Saturated and unsaturated solutions. So if more solute can be added, unsaturated. If it becomes unstable, we cannot add more, then it's saturated. And if you are heating and adding, then it's super saturated. Type of solution, gas, liquid, gas, solid is missing here. Liquid, gas is also missing here. Liquid, solid is there. So similarly, these are the examples you can go through once. Now these are the topics we want to take up, that is concentration terms, mass percentage, volume percentage, strength, molarity, molality, normality, mole fraction, ppm. Let us start. Mass percentage is having no unit, mass of solute divided by mass of solution into 100. Okay. Mass percentage, W by B means mass percentage, means mass of solute dissolved in 100 ml of solution, gram per milliliter. Volume, that's same as you know. Next, strength is mass of solute by volume of solution into 1000. Its formulas are given with normality and molarity. Molarity, number of moles of solute dissolved per liter of the solution, gram moles per liter. Temperature dependent, which is temperature dependent, please note that. Molality is the moles of solute dissolved per kg of solvent. It's independent of temperature, does not depend on temperature, because it does not depend on volume, it depends on mass. That's why. Normality, number of gram equivalent of solute dissolved per liter of the solution. Units are gram equivalent per liter, temperature dependent. Mole fraction, moles of solute divided by total moles. If A or B two components are there, moles of A divided by total moles. PPM, volume of gas multiplied by 10 to the power 6 volume of solution divided by volume of solution. It is used to measure the pollution level. So let us recap whatever we have learned so far. Normality, normality is the number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution. Molarity, number of moles of solute dissolved per liter of the solution. Molality, number of moles of solute in 1 kg of solvent. Then we have discussed about the homogeneous and heterogeneous, then we have discussed about the acidic, basic and neutral solution, then we discussed about the type of solutions, the 9 different systems, and hypertonic, isotonic and hypotonic. If the concentration is same, if two solution having concentration same, that's known as isotonic. If concentration of solution is more, then it is known as hyper. If the concentration of solution is less, then it is hypo. So these are some of the formulas we need to keep in mind. So I have been a little bit faster. You can stop the video and see there. I feel that you should read one, go through once and again go recap once more. So let us review again the thought: hard work pays off. So thank you to all of you. This is all. These videos will be available in YouTube channel. So please continue doing the good works. Thank you very much.